Thank you for logging on to arabnews.com. We have with us today one of the most prominent members of the Indian community in Saudi Arabia, Dr. M.S. Karimuddin. We will speak to him about the changes that have taken place in this country in the last 3 decades. He has been here, and as member of the expat community, he has contributed immensely to the development of new Saudi Arabia. Let us speak to Dr. M.S. Karimuddin. Hello, Dr. Karimuddin.
Hi, hello.
It's a pleasure to have you on our program.
Thank you.
First things first, can you tell us or can you take us to the Saudi Arabia when you landed in? What year was that?
Yes, it was March 1980. When I was passing through Saudi Arabia, I landed in Jeddah.
Mm-hmm.
That time I came for Umrah, and one of my friends from my city of Madras, he took me from the airport and he took me to the Umrah. And then while coming back, we passed by a building called Bukhshan Hospital.
In Jeddah.
In Jeddah. Mm. And that time, Bukhshan Hospital was the end of the city.
Okay.
It was built on the end of the city.
Mm-hmm.
So then he said that he has some connection with the hospital. So I'm being a pediatrician. He said, why don't you try here to work?
Mm-hmm.
I said, no, my intention was going back to India. Then he said, no harm in trying. So we just went there in the basement. It was a small office. We met the Director General, Dr. Hassan, Dr. Hassan.
Okay. At Bukhshan Hospital.
Yeah, Bukhshan Hospital. So he saw my CV and he offered me a job.
Okay.
And then we came out, and then we got going back to his house, my friend's house. So I told him that I really wanted to go back to India.
Okay.
But then he said, no, Dr. Sir, take it from me. That you get a job here and you can work happily here. I said, no, okay, even if I get a job, I am going to be there for only 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
So this friend of mine, he took a 50 rial note and gave to me to smell.
Uh-huh.
I was taken aback. And what the hell am I going to smell the... 50 rial note. I smelled it and gave it back to him obligingly. And he said, take it from me, you are going to be here more than 25 years.
Just because you smell the 50 rial bill.
But that was by the way, and I came on a visa. I went back to India, came on a visa, and I started my journey in Saudi Arabia in 1980, October,
mm-hmm.
as a pediatrician in Bukhshan Hospital.
Was this the same airport that you landed, or was it the old airport?
No, I landed in Sara 15, the old airport. When I landed, the new airport was not there.
Mm-hmm.
So then in 1980, when I came back for the job, I think I landed in the new airport. By the time the new airport was started.
Oh, so within a very short span, you landed in two different airports in the city of Jeddah.
Yeah, they were getting it ready. So by the time I came back to Saudi Arabia, I was landed there. And there was a World Islamic Conference.
Okay.
Being held on that year in Makkah Mukarrama. So the new highway of Makkah. When I came for Umrah, I went to Makkah on the old road, and also to Medina on the old road.
Okay.
But by the time I came back, this new road was opened, and we had a pleasure of driving on one of the best roads in the world.
From 1980 to 2013, it's a long, long, long journey. How have you seen Saudi Arabia progress from what it was in 1980 to what it is in 2013?
It's tremendous. As I told you, that this Bukhshan Hospital was the end of the city. Now you see where the city has gone, you know, by infrastructure and also the quality of education, the universities, and the medical facilities, particularly. But when I came here in 1980, Bukhshan was one of the few private hospitals. We can count on the hand. But now you see, this is one of the best center for medical treatment for the whole of Middle East. And in fact, one of our aims in the Indo-Saudi Medical Forum, which I formed, is to encourage medical tourism bilaterally. And we want even Indian patients who cannot afford to go to America and all these things, people, we want them to come here also. The Indo-Saudi Medical Forum is aiming at that. While we are also going to encourage medical tourism for India, but at the same time we are focusing on bringing patients in here. You can imagine that much development has taken place here.
Dr. Karimuddin, one of the things that I've heard you say is that when you landed in Saudi Arabia, or Jeddah to be more specific, the one thing that sent thrill, you know, in you was when you discovered Arab News, that there is an English newspaper. Can you tell us about your association?
Yeah, exactly. Two things thrilled me here when I came for Umrah first time, and then second in October. In the first span of 6 months, I came back with a job. The one thing was I'm crazy about reading newspapers. And even I was in Libya before I landed here. In Libya, I used to get the Hindu International Edition, which comes in
the Indian newspaper.
Fortnight, yeah.
The Indian newspaper,
Hindu. By post. Mm-hmm. By post.
Oh, you'll get it by post in Libya, in Tripoli.
Yeah, twice a month. I okay. I'm that much crazy of reading newspaper. So then there was no English newspapers in Libya at all. Uh-huh. There were Arab newspapers and Italian newspapers.
Okay.
So then when I came and landed here in Jeddah, when I saw the Arab news first time, I was really thrilled. And then from that day till today, I have to read the Arab news. There's no way I can sleep without reading it.
So Arab news has been able to chronicle the journey, right way?
Yes. It was one of the main attractions for me to stay long back in Saudi Arabia, because I could get some English newspapers to read about.
You are associated with the medical field, and over these 30 years, three decades, you've seen young Saudis come up. There is a change in their attitude towards the work and all that. And now we see young Saudis taking up jobs, taking managerial positions. Would you like to say something on that?
Exactly. Because, you know, the kingdom has provided such excellent medical facilities. For example, in the field of immunization.
Mm-hmm.
The immunization here, they have made compulsory. So much so that you won't get your birth certificate unless you complete 1 year immunization.
True.
You know, the basic immunizations you have to get, all the children, otherwise you won't get your birth certificate. Mm-hmm. See, that is a compulsion which made children to be protected from very serious diseases. And naturally, when they are protected from serious diseases, they are not often on the antibiotics, they are not often on the medication, so they have a healthy growth.
Okay.
And the nutrition is very good here. Or they get very good nutrition, which is important for the growth of the brain, the memory center, their grasping power, everything grew. And then the Saudi boys, particularly boys and girls whom I have been treating from Bukhtan years, they were growing in good strength. Mm-hmm. And they were studying well. And I have some of my colleagues, Saudi doctors, they are on par with anybody in the world.
They are on par?
Yeah, on par in the world. Most of them have done their fellowship from America, fellowship from Canada, and a membership from UK, and they are on par. And even now, I used to learn a lot from them.
If I can ask you for five Saudis who really made an impact on you, would you be able to name them now?
Yes, one is Dr. Khalid Mutabughani.
Okay.
He is the son of my chairman of the hospital. He is a pediatric surgeon. New Jeddah Clinic Hospital, the chairman's son.
Okay.
He studied in America for 15 years. He did pediatric surgery. Mm-hmm. And he was one of the few Saudi pediatric surgeons in Jeddah.
Okay.
Yeah. There is another one, Dr. Abdul Wahab. He's a kidney transplant surgeon.
Okay.
He qualified in Canada and he does excellent job here.
Mm-hmm.
And then the third one I could remember is Raj Khan. He's an endocrinologist.
Okay.
He's a professor of endocrinology in King Abdulaziz University, and he does his private clinic in my hospital.
Okay.
And I'm very happy to refer patients to him.
Mm-hmm.
The fourth one I can remember is Dr. Reema Badar.
Dr. Reema Badar?
Reema Badar. She's a pediatric cardiologist. And it's a very rare. And she's an excellent pediatric cardiologist. A Saudi doctor, educated in America. Still, she goes to America very frequently, gives lectures on pediatric cardiology.
Mm-hmm.
And excellent. I refer all my pediatric cardiac cases to her.
Dr. Reema Badar.
And is very good in doing echo and all those things.
Okay.
The fifth doctor whom I remember, now at the moment I'm working with is Abdurrahim Jamjum.
Abdurrahim, Dr. Abdurrahim Jamjum?
Jamjum. He's an orthopedic surgeon.
Okay.
And I think he's the best in the Western region.
Okay.
Best in the Western region. If anybody has any knee problems, he is the one who takes care of. He also does his private practice in my hospital.
Dr. Karimuddin, this must be a moment of pride for you to see Saudis coming up and taking challenging positions and all that. What would you be telling the young Saudis who are still coming back and want to replace people who are from outside? What would be your message as to how they should do more?
They are very good in their field, well-trained and well-mannered and everything. But what message I want to give to them is, this is your country and this is your hospital. Never mind that you are working under another Saudi. Never mind that. But as a medical professional, we are not bothered about under whom we are working. We are working for the community.
Mm-hmm.
We are working for the children. And it doesn't matter to me. To me, it doesn't matter who is running the hospital. But I am concerned only with my patients. So I want my Saudi colleagues to stick to their positions. Suppose you are working in my hospital as a pediatric cardiologist, please stick to my hospital, because I'm looking upon you. I am looking forward to send my patients to you. But unfortunately, many of them are not able to continue in one position. They keep changing. So that doesn't augur well, because the patients has to have a continuity.
Dr. Karimuddin, you are a very prominent member of the Indian expat community in Jeddah. You've been the chairman of the Indian School in Jeddah, which is a massive institution. You worked there as a chairman. You've been a member of the higher board that is tasked with running the affairs of the Indian schools in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. What are the most pressing issues in terms of education for the Indian community? What are the most pressing issues?
Pressing issues, yeah. Pressing issues are a few. And one is, the schools, which has such a huge population of students, they are not unable to get permanent teachers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about 10 years back, but now the things have changed, and the teachers we have opted for this school, they are sticking on. The reason being, the standard of education has gone up very well.
Okay.
Because the teachers who have been there for a longer time, they are very, very, very loyal to the school and loyal to the children and the parents. And then the head of the institution, like now the present principal, Masood.
Sayyid Masood Ahmed.
Yeah, Mr. Masood, is very loyal to the school. And a man who doesn't even take private tuitions when he was a teacher.
Okay.
Yeah, I can quote an example. My son wanted to do medicine, so I had to put him in biology. He was a biology teacher at that time.
Okay.
So I want my son to score the maximum marks, then only he can get into medical school. So I asked him once, can you take few hours of private tuition to my son? He flatly refused. He said, I will take extra classes within the school
hours, compound,
but not in my house.
Uh-huh.
Such a character.
That commitment.
Yeah, that commitment. And that has built up the school very nicely. And of course, there were, I as a part of management, I did my best to give them a free hand as much as academics are concerned. See, we are not academicians, so we should not interfere in that.
The day-to-day running of the school, you mean?
Yeah, day-to-day running, not in the academic side. Yeah, okay. Academic side, we have nothing to do with the academic side. And this is my personal advice to anybody coming into the managing committee. Please leave the school alone as far as academic is concerned to the principal and his core committee.
Okay.
Now, the teachers were leaving suddenly. When I became the higher board member 3 years back, I signed about 48 checks in a year of end of benefit
teachers leaving.
That means the 48 teachers were leaving. So that is the time I put my foot down and I argued in the higher board to increase their salaries.
Okay.
Because the salaries were very poor.
Okay.
But how to increase the salary? We have to naturally have better income. So that is the idea of increasing the school fees. Even now, with all this increase in the school fees, our school is the cheapest in the kingdom.
Okay.
With that, we were able to retain the teachers.
Okay.
And most of them are retained. And also, we were able to recruit teachers from India, because in India, now the things have gone ahead. The development is great. The doctors.
And there are more opportunities. There are less people who are coming.
Salaries are very good. Unbelievable salaries they are getting. When we went for an interview, when we offered this salary, they laughed at you. They said, for this salary, you came all this way. Same thing happened. Fortunately, I was connected with two interviews, and one for the teachers and one for the doctors.
Okay.
I went for a doctor's interview with my chairman. We went to three cities, Madras, Bombay, Delhi. And for your information, in Madras, only one doctor turned up for the interview.
Uh-huh.
Only one doctor came for the interview saying that we are not interested going abroad because our salaries are very good here. When he came to Bombay, one of the leading recruiting agency, a recruiting agency which employs about 120 staff in their office, they told us that they gave up recruiting doctors because nobody is coming for interview.
Okay.
What they do is they send their CVs to you. You have to scrutinize and call them on the Skype and interview them. And still you want to meet them, you come down to Bombay, we'll take you to the doctor.
Okay.
So it's very difficult to get doctor unless we increase the school fees according to the salaries what we are offering, then we are going to face great problems in the school. The other drawbacks in these schools, in the community schools here, are the space.
Okay.
The classrooms are overcrowded and they're not proper playgrounds for the school, because physical education is one of the important aspects of a child's life. As a pediatrician, I know how important it is, the physical education. And also the CBSC put a lot of emphasis on the physical education.
You mean the Indian Education Board?
Yeah, the CBSC, Central Board of
Secondary Education.
Mm-hmm. They have, and then they have a subject on physical education, and then there is a mark for the promotion on the physical education. So our schools, community schools, should come up with proper playgrounds, proper programming and all this. During my chairmanship, I introduced a lot of clubs in the school.
Okay.
Club activities, I introduced a lot of club activities. They are all going on.
Dr. M.S. Karimuddin, a lot of people are watching you on ArabNews.com. Would you like to say something to the readers of Arab News?
Yeah. Arab News is one of the only English dependable newspaper in Jeddah, and you can get a lot of information on the field of medical and education and even commercial. And I'm not a commercial man, I'm not a businessman, but still it's very interesting newspaper, and we all should support this newspaper, and then we all should respect the rules and regulations of the kingdom. This is my important message. We should all not get upset with whatever is going on of late, but we have to really respect the kingdom. And I really love, and now I pray for King Abdullah's speedy recovery. We want to see him back on his feet, and he is a wonderful leader.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The most dependable newspaper in the kingdom. That was Dr. M.S. Karimuddin. Thank you very much for watching another episode of Arab News New Media Channel. Stay tuned. Thank you very much.